From this lecture of signal sense systems, we are going to start operation on the continuous time signals. Operations which can be performed on the continuous time signals can be classified as addition and the subtraction of the continuous time signal, multiplication of the continuous time signal, scaling operation which includes time scaling of the continuous time signal and amplitude scaling of the continuous time signal, shifting operation which also includes time shifting and amplitude shifting of the continuous time signal, and finally reversal operation which also includes time reversal and the amplitude reversal of the continuous time signal. In this lecture of signals and systems, we are going to see addition, subtraction and the multiplication of the continuous time signal or CTS. We know that the continuous time signal is defined for every instant of time. So the addition, subtraction and the multiplication of two or more continuous time signals can be obtained by performing corresponding operations at every instant of time. Addition of the two continuous time signal. Let's take two continuous time signal termed as x1t and x2t and add them together. After the addition, resultant signal is x3t. So mathematically x3t is equal to x1t plus x2t. The addition of the signal x1t and x2t must be done for every instant of time in order to obtain x3t. Now let's see how to add the signal x1t with x2t to obtain the signal x3t. At first, we take the signal x1t, where x-axis is defined for the time t and y-axis is defined for the amplitude of the signal x1t. Then we take the signal x2t. Similarly, x-axis is defined for the time t and y-axis is defined for the amplitude of the signal x2t. Similarly, for the resultant signal x3t, which is the addition of the signal x1t and x2t, we have to take the signal amplitude in the y-axis and time t in the x-axis. Now, for the addition of the signal x1t and x2t, we have to perform the addition for every instant of time. So, when the time t is greater than or equal to 3 and less than or equal to 4, then the value of the signal x1t is equal to 2 and the value of the signal x2t is equal to 2. The signal x3t, which is the result of the addition of the signal x1t and x2t, will become 2 plus 2, which is equal to 4. So, for the time t greater than or equal to 3 and less than or equal to 4, the value of the signal x3t is equal to 4. Now, for the time t is greater than or equal to 2 and less than or equal to 3, then the value of the signal x1t is equal to 1 and value of the signal x2t is equal to 2. And the resultant signal x3t, which is the addition of the signal x1t and x2t, is equal to 1 plus 2, which is equal to 3. So, for the time t greater than or equal to 2 and less than or equal to 3, the value of the signal x3t is equal to 3. When the time t is greater than or equal to 1 and less than or equal to 2, then the value of the signal x1t is equal to 1 and the value of the signal x2t is equal to minus 1. So, the resultant signal x3t, which is the addition of the signal x1t and x2t, will become 1 plus minus 1, which is equal to 0. So, for the time t greater than or equal to 1 and less than or equal to 2, the value of the signal x3t is equal to 0. Now, for the time t greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 1, the value of the signal x1t is equal to 2 and the value of the signal x2t is equal to 1. Then, the resultant signal x3t, which is the addition of the signal x1t and x2t, will become 2 plus 1, which is equal to 3. So, for the time t greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 1, the value of the signal x3t is equal to 3. And when the time t is greater than or equal to minus 1 and less than or equal to 0, then the value of the signal x1t is equal to 1 and the value of the signal x2t is also equal to 1. And the resultant signal x3t, which is the addition of the signal x1t and x2t, will become 1 plus 1, which is equal to 2. So for the time t greater than or equal to minus 1 and less than or equal to 0, the value of the signal x3t is equal to 2. And finally, when the time t is greater than or equal to minus 2 and less than or equal to minus 1, the value of the signal x1t is equal to 2 and the value of the signal x2t also equal to 2. So, the resultant signal x3t is equal to 2 plus 2, which is equal to 4. So, for the time instant t greater than or equal to minus 2 and less than or equal to minus 1, the value of the signal x3t is equal to 4. Now, let's see the subtraction of the two continuous time signal. Again, our two continuous time signals are x1t and x2t. We have to subtract x1t from x2t in order to obtain our resultant signal x3t. So mathematically it can be written as x3t is equal to x1t minus x2t. The subtraction of the signal x1t and x2t must be done for every instant of time in order to obtain the signal x3t. For this, again we take the signal x1t and x2t with amplitude defined in the y-axis and time t defined in the x-axis. Now, from these two signals, we have to plot the signal x3t, which is the subtraction of the signal x1t from the signal x2t. And for this subtraction, we have to subtract the signal x1t from the signal x2t at every instant of time. So when the time t is greater than or equal to 3 and less than or equal to 4, the value of the signal x1t is equal to 2 and x2t is also equal to 2. So the resultant signal x3t, which is the subtraction of the signal x1t from the signal x2t, is 2 minus 2, which is equal to 0. So when the time t is greater than or equal to 3 and less than or equal to 4, the value of the signal x3t is equal to 0. Again, when the time t greater than or equal to 2 and less than or equal to 3, then the value of the signal x1t is equal to 1 and the value of the signal x2t is equal to 2. Then the resultant signal x3t, which is the subtraction of the signal x1t from the signal x2t, is equal to 1 minus 2, which will result in minus 1. So when the time t is greater than or equal to 2 and less than or equal to 3, the value of the signal x3t is equal to minus 1. Now when the time t is greater than or equal to 1 and less than or equal to 2, the value of the signal x1t is equal to 1 and the value of the signal x2t is equal to minus 1. So the resultant signal, which is the subtraction of the signal x1t from the signal x2t, will be 1 minus minus 1, which is equal to 2. So for the time t greater than or equal to 1 and less than or equal to 2, the value of the signal x3t is equal to 2. Now when the time t is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 1, then the value of the signal x1t is equal to 2 and the signal x2t is equal to 1. So the resultant signal x3t, which is the subtraction of the signal x1t from the signal x2t, will be 2 minus 1, which is equal to 1. So for the time t greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 1, the value of the signal x3t is equal to 1. Now, when the time t is greater than or equal to minus 1 and less than or equal to 0, then the value of the signal x1t is equal to 1 and the value of the signal x2t is also equal to 1. Then the resultant signal x3t, which is equal to x1t minus x2t, is equal to 1 minus 1, which is equal to 0. So for the time t greater than or equal to minus 1 and less than or equal to 0, the value of the signal x3t is equal to 0. And finally, when the time t is greater than or equal to minus 2 and less than or equal to minus 1, the value of the signal x1t is equal to 2 and also the value of the signal x2t is equal to 2. So the resultant signal x3t, which is equal to x1t minus x2t, is equal to 2 minus 2, which is equal to 0. So for the time t greater than or equal to minus 2 and less than or equal to minus 1, the value of the signal x3t is equal to 0. Again, for the multiplication of the two continuous time signals, we take the continuous time signals x1t and x2t and we have to multiply x1t by x2t. After the multiplication, the resultant signal is x3t. So mathematically, x3t is equal to multiplication of x1t with x2t. The multiplication of the x1t and x2t must be performed for every instant of time in order to obtain the signal x3t. Now, we have to take the signal x1t and x2t with the signal amplitude in the y-axis and the time t in the x-axis. And the resultant signal x3t, which is the multiplication of the signal x1t and x3t, will also have the amplitude in the y-axis and the time t in the x-axis. Again, when the time t is greater than or equal to 3 and less than or equal to 4, then the value of the signal x1t is equal to 2 and the value of the signal x2t is also equal to 2. So the resultant signal x3t, which is the multiplication of the signal x1t and x2t, is equal to 2 into 2, which is equal to 4. So for the time t greater than or equal to 3 and less than or equal to 4, the value of the signal x3t is equal to 4. Again, on the time t is greater than or equal to 2 and less than or equal to 3, the value of the signal x1t is equal to 1 and the value of the signal x2t is equal to 2. The resultant signal x3t, which is the multiplication of the signal x1t and the signal x2t, is equal to 1 into 2, which is equal to 2. So for the time t greater than or equal to 2 and less than or equal to 3, the value of the signal xt is equal to 2. And now when the time t greater than or equal to 1 and less than or equal to 2, the value of the signal x1t is equal to 1 and the value of the signal x2t is equal to minus 1. So the resultant signal x3t, which is the multiplication of the signal x1t and x2t, is equal to 1 into minus 1, which is equal to minus 1. So for the time t greater than or equal to 1 and less than or equal to 2, the value of the signal x3t is equal to minus 1. Now again, when the time t is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 1, the value of the signal x1t is equal to 2 and the value of the signal x2t is equal to 1. So the resultant signal x3t, which is the multiplication of the signal x1t and x2t, is equal to 2 into 1, which is equal to 2. So for the time t greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 1, the value of the signal x3t is equal to 2. When the time t is greater than or equal to minus 1 and less than or equal to 0, then the value of the signal x1t is equal to 1 and the value of the signal x2t is also equal to 1. So the resultant signal x3t is equal to 1 into 1, which is equal to 1. So for the time t is greater than or equal to minus 1 and less than or equal to 0, the value of the signal is 1. Finally, when the time t is greater than or equal to minus 2 and less than or equal to minus 1, the value of the signal x1t is equal to 2 and the value of the signal x2t is also equal to 2. So the resultant signal x3t, which is the multiplication of the signal x1t and x2t, is equal to 2 into 2, which is equal to 4. So for the time t greater than or equal to minus 2 and less than or equal to minus 1, the value of the signal x3t is equal to 4. That's all for this lecture. If you have any doubts regarding this lecture, then you may ask it in the comment section. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.